intends to cause her to be confined and imprisoned against her will, contrary to 9 wrongful amateur section 22.7. Having had the charge, how do you plead?
Not guilty.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I begin with some general comments on our roles in this trial. Throughout these proceedings, I'll ask of the judge. And you will be the judge of the facts. Although I may comment on the evidence, as judges of the facts, you are the exclusive judges of the evidence. By the same token, when I tell you what the law is, it is my view of the law that must prevail. There are two other basic principles that are fundamental to your role as jury. They are the requirement for proof beyond a reasonable doubt and the presumption of innocence. The requirement for proof beyond a reasonable doubt means that no person accused of an offense can be found guilty unless the prosecutor proves each and every fact or element of that offense beyond a reasonable doubt. Similarly, our system of law requires that an accused person be presumed innocent. Tarzan has no obligation to prove that he is not guilty or to explain to you the evidence offered to you by the prosecutor. The law presumes he is innocent until you establish otherwise. Before calling on counsel to give the opening statements, I will tell you something about the offense with which Tarzan has been charged with. The prosecutor has charged Tarzan with kidnapping Jane against her will. Before you can legally return a guilty verdict on kidnapping against one's will, the prosecutor must prove each of the following elements beyond a reasonable doubt. First, the identity of Tarzan as the offender. Second, the date and place of the offense. Third, Tarzan confined and imprisoned Jane. Fourth, Tarzan did assault Jane for the purpose of kidnapping her. Fifth, that Tarzan confined and imprisoned Jane wrongfully. And sixth, Tarzan confined and imprisoned Jane against her will. I now call upon the prosecutor to give the opening statement.
Your Honor, and ladies and gentlemen of the jury, we intend to prove that Tarzan confined and imprisoned Jane, and that he intended to kidnap her, knowing that what he was doing was a crime. To support our case, we intend to call the following witnesses: Clay Shepard, Jane's father, Professor Porter, and Jane herself. Thank you.
And I'll call upon the defense to give the opening statement.
Your Honor, and ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the prosecutor wants us to believe that Tarzan stole Jane away and deliberately kept her against her will. The prosecutor's case has no shred of truth. If it were not for Tarzan, Jane probably would not be alive today. Tarzan saved Jane in trouble, and now he is being punished for it. As the judge explained, to be guilty of kidnapping, you must assault someone, and in doing so, take them away with you. Admittedly, Tarzan did assault and take Jane, but it was an act of heroism. Tarzan did so to save her. Being raised in the jungle, and in the absence of any fellow human beings, has affected Tarzan. He could not have known how to understand Jane's feelings, as he didn't even speak English. The evidence you will hear today will cast a reasonable doubt on the prosecutor's case. It will show that Tarzan had no intent at all to kidnap the reporter.
What happened on the morning of June
14, 1899? My neighbor, Professor Porter, told me he was going on a trip to an isolated island in Africa. He mentioned something about AIDS. All I cared about was going there and practicing my shooting skills on those filthy creatures. I think that interest is hooked.
Who else was going on this trip?
The professor's daughter, James.
What happened when you arrived on the island?
Well, we set up camp, and I must say that island was typically a massive jungle. No wonder Tarzan was able to hide so easily.
What did you do after setting up camp?
We ventured into the jungle and Jane got separated from us.
Did you try to find her?
No.
there when she came back?
Yes, and what she did, she was telling us about all these things that happened to her in the jungle. She was talking so quickly that the only thing I was able to hear was something about an ape man.
An ape man, you say?
Yes. And all of a sudden, this strange creature jumped out in front of Jason, and his ape friend walked up behind him. There was also an elephant not too far behind him.
So what did you do?
I tried to shoot at them because they could have attacked me, and I didn't want her to get hurt. But just when, as I was aiming, Jane must have pushed me, making my gun shoot upwards towards the sky.
Is this ape man in the courtroom today?
Yes.
Let the record show that the witness has identified the accused. No further questions.
Does the defense wish to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. Now, Clayton, you said you went on this trip to get some shooting practice. Yes or no?
Sort of.
The answer is yes or no, Mr. Jeffrey.
Yes. But I also went there to protect her from certain things.
So why did you see her look for Jane when she got separated from the other professors?
I guess I just assumed that Jane was smart enough to find her way back to town since she was the daughter of a professor.
You went to Africa to hunt animals, right?
Yes, but I went to Africa on a vacation, not to work.
Then why did you bring your gun? Your trip is purely recreational.
To protect Jane and the professor.
But that wasn't your main goal when she got lost a few days.
Yes, I wanted to protect her, but I guess I didn't.
Clayton, once again, is it not true that one of your main reasons for going on this trip to Africa was to get to hunt and damage animals? I'm mind you, you were under oath.
Yes.
Thank you. No further questions.
Thank you, Clayton. You may step down. Prosecutor, you may call your next witness.
You call Professor Porter. I'm Professor Akimiri Reporter, and I live in the same apartment complex that Mr. Shepherd called me in the hill. Professor, what happened on the morning of June 14, 1899? Well, I had taken a trip down to an African island. I was planning to study some ape species. Jane went off into the jungle with her sketchbook. I didn't see her for the next 2 days. Did you try to find her? Yes, but Clayton and I didn't have much luck.
So then what did you do?
Well, this ape man was following her, and I tried to take her away again when Clayton tried to shoot him. Jane pushed Clayton and his gun fired into the air. Then the ape man ran away into the jungle.
Did you see this ape man in the courtroom today?
Yes, he is right over there.
Let the record show that the witness has identified the accused. When Jane came back, was she alright?
Jane was very excited about her discovery of this ape man, but she was also a bit traumatized because her time with the ape man.
Are you okay with Tarzan taking your daughter?
I felt really angry, but at the same time, I was happy she was safe. After all, if Tarzan is really an ape man, then he couldn't have known any better.
Do you feel that you can trust Tarzan in any way to what has happened?
Well, not really. Yes, he may be an ape man, but that is even more reason to stay away from him. He could also be dangerous. I personally stay away from him.
No further questions.
Does the defense wish to cross-examine this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. Isn't it true that James said even though he was proved, he still wants to see the ape man because she thought he was the missing link to the theory of evolution?
Well, yes, but...
So Jane wanted to learn more about Tarzan?
Yes.
Professor Porter, did you say that Tarzan couldn't have known even better when he allegedly kidnapped your daughter?
Yes, I did. I don't think it's personally his fault.
So Tarzan wasn't aware of his actions?
Probably not.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Professor, you may step down. Prosecutor, you can call your next witness.
He called Jane.
Please raise your right hand. Do you swear that the evidence you shall give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Oh, why, of course.
quite well to hear a record of the proceedings.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. Please state your full name and address.
I'm Jane Coulson, living with my father in an apartment complex called London Hills.
Jane, where were you on the morning of June 14, 1899?
I was on a remote African island where my father was in Korea.
Did you see any group?
Yes.
Did you have any sort of relationship with them?
Not until after we set up camp, and I ventured off with them into the jungle with my sketchbook. In there, this little family took my sketchbook and ran off with it. I chased him and got my sketchbook from him. He then started to jump in a strange way, and all these adult baboons rushed out to the jungle and started attacking me.
What happened next?
Tarzan swooped down from the pine tree and pushed me up high to the pine tree. He set me down on an elevated area and I stepped into this pine tree. He then grabbed me and started moving closer to me. I thought it was awfully rude.
How close?
Well, first he touched my hand, which I found very offensive, and then he sniffed at my hair. I was extremely appalled.
What did you do? How long were you gone?
3 days.
How did you manage to get away from that?
Well, when Tarzan was asleep, I climbed down from the trees and ran through the jungle back to my camp. Then Tarzan woke up and chased after me. But I got back to my father before he could catch me. That was when I presented close to him shooting Tarzan.
Do you see this Tarzan in the foreground today?
Yes, he's sitting in the tree stump over there.
Does the record show that the witness has identified the accused Tarzan? No further questions.
So the defense has examined this witness?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor. Jane, wouldn't it be correct to say that Tarzan saved the person that I believe?
Yes, but he still kept moving on the island.
So you eventually got away, didn't you?
Yes.
Did Tarzan hurt you?
No.
So why are you accusing Tarzan of kidnapping you when all you did was save your life?
Well, I was thankful for that to save my life, but he still kept me against my will.
Did Tarzan speak or understand English?
I don't think so.
And how could he have known that you wanted to leave?
Well, I thought I made it pretty soon.
He only lives to animals, is that correct? Do you think Tarzan was just curious about you, as he had never seen a human before?
I know.
Wasn't the jungle quite dangerous?
Well, it should have been that way when the baboons attacked me.
Do you think it's possible that Tarzan wanted to suspect you by keeping you close?
Yeah, I guess that's why he was being so
Thank you. No further questions for the prisoner.
Jane, you need to step down. Prosecutor, call your next witness.
The prosecutor rests his case, Your Honor.
Defense, you may call your first witness.